The president was very brief, but the legislative program will see this country moving forward. The economic underpinning of what he has said is what we are going to implement. And for immediate, we have to look at the disaster that has unfolded in the city of Harare and other urban local authorities. But the president has given a green light of how to solve it in the short term and the long term. And we want to make it a permanent point so that we clean up our cities. There is a causal effect between vending unclean food and the incidence of typhoid and cholera.
Well, we continue to fight it. The containment plan is in place, and we are making sure that all the centers, the treatment centers, are well staffed or well stocked, and in the community, enough water being made available, because that's a key issue right now, clean water, so that they don't use contaminated water. Plus contaminated food, contaminated water, contaminated food, so I'm really very happy that government is coming in a big way, cabinet approved, and wants to ensure that the source of the problems are taken care of. So if all the water sanitation and sewers are unblocked and repaired, we'll get somewhere. So this is what I'm saying. From the purification area, there has to be a proper purification of water. The water sources, boreholes, must be cleaned out.
No, I did not announce any plan. I want to be clear. But the proposals, these are just options. But we have clarity that the current system is in place. Let's work with it, the current system, and then in the fullness of time, we will build the building blocks where we eventually move towards a Zimbabwe dollar. There's no timetable for that.
Oh, we're dealing with it.
We're doing our best. Without being specific, we can be sure of that. On the international front, we're trying to source credit lines. I think you saw a credit line for $250 million that we announced a couple of days ago. We've done another one for $100 million is coming through as well. So we'll continue to build the credit lines, to build foreign reserves as part of the strategy, but also we need to build and support gold output, because that's what gives us the leverage for more comprehensive currency reforms. Then on the fiscal front, as the president already said, we need to bring fiscal equilibrium, where we cut expenditure, reduce budget deficit to single digit, as well as make sure that we broaden the tax base and then bring the whole fiscus under control. It's important to have a medium-term horizon, I would say over like a three-year period, so that we can have a roadmap as to where the budget deficit should be headed. And then externally, naturally is to have this resolution on the arrears clearance, working on options, and the roadmap will be progressed soon with our international partners. This morning I met with the Ambassador Lang of the UK. As you know, the UK has been a great partner for Zimbabwe. In many ways, they've given us £1 billion since 2009, but also they've been a wonderful partner on the whole arrears clearance forum that we've gone into. So that's the roadmap. I mean, obviously going forward, government will be able to announce a more comprehensive transitional and stabilization program, which will work on and utilize over the next 2 years before we move on to a longer term plan, which will then really lift us into that middle income status that we so aspire for by year 2030.
He emphasized on the need to ensure that our ICT is in line with the international trends. He spoke about connectivity. I believe that ICT plays an integral role in any economic development, the world over. So we will, as a ministry, do our utmost to ensure that we bring the standard or the level of ICT in this country to international levels. And also we'll try and ensure that ICT plays the role that it is supposed to play in the economic development of our country, to say the very least.
that as a second republic, the president's speech is showing that we have to be busy building this country. Mainly, that is the main point, democratizing it and industrializing it, which basically means our efforts have to be towards production and poverty alleviation.